Chances are they are among the 125 million people playing the popular video game Fortnite. Young Australians, mostly school-aged boys, are playing it, talking about it, dancing the game's moves around the clock, and it's driving some parents crazy. Now consider this. The World Health Organization has just recognized gaming disorder as a medical condition, and some parents are flocking to professionals to pry their kids away. But for others, the game is just like any other hobby. It's all about balance. Ashlyn McGee reports.
If Mum and Dad weren't around, I would play Fortnite for 24/7.
Yeah, I would love that game. I got 8 kills.
Do you reckon he is addicted?
Yes, definitely. He plays it every day. Plays it every morning, plays it every night.
How many?
I really want to get him back into playing football, getting on with you think Hacker. You can hear him?
Oh my god, it's no, no.
Meet Riley Holzinger and his mum Angie.
Of course you're hungry. Well, I'm gonna cook some gin, and gin's gonna be in about half an hour.
For months now, it's been a challenge to pry the 11-year-old from Melbourne away from the popular video game.
I could see this aggression starting to form, take place. Started being rude, and I thought, oh my god, this game is going to drive me mad. Since Fortnite's been around, there is no skateboard, no scootering. He loves to be in that room 24/7. If he could stay awake, he would.
Fortnite Battle Royale is a pop culture phenomenon. 125 million people are playing it worldwide.
It's the online game that has fans in a frenzy.
At the moment, it's the biggest game on the internet.
Welcome, everybody, to the Fortnite Pro-Am!
This is one of those viral games that is literally sucking productivity out of schools, out of workplaces.
A huge part of the success is the Battle Royale mode.
The 100 players virtually fighting it out until one is left.
And the game even has its own dance moves. Bargaining chip. Eating dinner with the family and doing homework buys Riley more time on the game.
I like that you can talk to your friends online and have fun. Like you can be last one standing and there's new updates like basically every week.
What about Ninja? Have you played Ninja yet?
I'm not that addicted.
What do you mean not that addicted?
Well, like, kind of. But, I get off when I kind of want to.
But plenty of kids don't. And parents across Australia are flocking to seminars like this one in Sydney to find out what to do.
My name's Brad Marshall. I'm the principal psychologist at North Shore Kids Base, and I'm also the director of the Internet Addiction Clinic.
Brad Marshall runs parents through the basics of the game.
Essentially think of the Hunger Games in a game.
Then opens the floor to questions. Say a group of six mates that they all want to stay at home together.
The dark side of that is that when they encounter something like a predator online.
If you can get them out of the addiction, do they regain their skills?
In the Internet Addiction Clinic at KidSpace, we're seeing about 60 to 70% of the kids that come through the door are reporting that Fortnite is their primary game of use.
Brad says it's worse than other popular video games because it's free, can be played on lots of different devices, and is designed to be addictive.
Some kids have struggled to get to sleep at all. So that might mean going to sleep at 2 or 3 or 4 in the morning. It might mean not sleeping at all. For other kids, it'll be falling behind in homework or just not handing in assessments that they're supposed to be doing at school. And then we've also seen quite a lot of the anger outbursts at home, which can lead to a lot of conflict in the family.
What the f***?
Nine-year-old Max Pinton-Mason only started playing Fortnite a few months ago.
Today is the best day of the world. When my parents were gone, I would just play it the whole day. Chips, Coke, I'll be set for life.
Max,
mum Anna is trying to encourage a healthy balance between Fortnite and his other activities.
Are you going to have it here in your room?
My room?
My room? First thing he gets up in the morning, he'll like grab the iPad, play Fortnite. He's a little bit addicted, I would say, yes, because when I try to limit it and take that time off Fortnite, yes, we get into an argument. So then I'll have to bribe him.
Grab your bag.
He plays in the morning, in the afternoon, and on the hour-long drive to school each day in country Victoria.
I think for most people, it's something that they're very passionate about, that they enjoy. But going into addiction means that there's probably, it's not just a matter of time spent on a game, that there's psychological aspects where someone's becoming dependent on it.
Professor Murat Yücel is a clinical neuropsychologist at Monash University who specialises in addictions.
One of the things we're very much attracted to is reward. And these games are so rich, they're three-dimensional, rich with the potential for so many rewards. For example, you might have a small win and there's celebratory sounds that come through, or you have a small win and you unlock an option or get a new skin that's available. These are all things that reward you for effort along the way.
These small victories light up a part of the brain called the reward system.
It comes with a dopamine burst that hits the habit system.
And that's how behaviours become habits. Back at the Holzinger house, Riley's contemplating what he'd do without Fortnite.
Probably game raging, smashing stuff like getting sad and that.
What's the longest you've gone without playing?
About like 4 weeks.
How did you feel during those 4 weeks?
Relaxed, well, I went to my PS4 there.
Conversation in many households during these school holidays.